Happy Friday. Welcome back to my channel and welcome. If you are new here, I'm so glad that you clicked on today's video. I'm going to be sharing with you, as always, on Friday, the recap of the WW workshop. We're going to talk about my week, kind of talk about what my goals were for last week and if those fell into place this week. And of course, I'll be sharing my weigh-in with you. So without further ado, let's jump into this WW weekly weigh-in. Hope you guys are doing well. I hope you had a fantastic week. I had a pretty good week and I am so excited to share with you guys that I completed my big goal for this week, and that was to do Jazzercise 3 or more times. I did it, my friends. I worked out Saturday, Monday, and Wednesday, and I'm still sore. I am sore. Jazzercise always kicks my booty, but when I haven't done it for a few days, it's extra intense with the soreness, which, hey, sore means I worked hard. So I'm so proud of myself that I did that goal that I said that I was going to do. I also did extremely well on tracking, but I did want to let you guys know that I decided not to do the calorie cycling challenge experiment this last week because I filmed a What I Eat in a Week points versus calories that will be out on Sunday. So I had to stay within my normal caloric goal for that video so that it made sense and so that I could show you exactly what I was eating each day and compare those calories versus the points and see kind of where it all fell. So just a heads up that the calorie cycling didn't happen, but I am starting that today, Friday, and I will talk all about that next week. So I'm going to do calorie cycling this week and double track my points like I did this last week and let you guys know how all that plays out, not only on my weigh-in, but also kind of how I felt cycling my calories. So let's jump into this week's topic because I love it. And it's a topic that I think was far overdue on WW, and that is talking about fats. Healthy fats, saturated fats, unsaturated fats, and how to work those into your WW program. So we're going to talk about saturated fats. So think red meat, coconut oil, that type of thing for saturated fat, cheeses. And then we're going to talk about unsaturated fats, nuts, avocado oil, olive oil. And we're going to talk about how saturated and unsaturated fats play into a diet, as well as how they play into smart points. Now, both have smart points. They're just going to vary. And my leader, coach, talked about a saturated fat that I actually disagree with. So I want to talk to you guys about that as well. So I want to talk about some swaps that you can make if you're concerned about unsaturated versus saturated fat. So if you are somebody that loves butter, which who doesn't love butter, you can simply swap butter out for avocado. If you have not had avocado toast, it's amazing. It's better, in my opinion, than butter on toast. And avocados is an unsaturated, healthy fat for you. So you can swap out your butter or your light butter for avocado and get a lot more nutritional benefit, keep you a lot more satisfied and full because of all of those healthy fats. You can also swap out beef or pork for oily fishes such as salmon, tuna, sardines, that type of thing. Now, for me, you guys, I'm a red meat eater. I don't eat red meat every single day, but I like to have it a couple of times a week. And to be honest with you, I'm not too concerned about the saturated fat that I'm getting in that red meat because I'm not eating it every day. I'm not overdoing it and I enjoy it. And for me to make this a sustainable way of life, I have to eat the foods that I enjoy. I like fish. I don't love fish. And I don't want to eat fish in place of red meat and take out a portion of my diet. And that's where I agree and disagree about the saturated and unsaturated fats. I think it's important not to eat red meat 3 times a day every day, but I don't think that there's anything wrong with balance and moderation and having red meat every once in a while, a couple, 2-3 times a week. You can also replace croutons on your salad because croutons are generally cooked in some type of oil. You can replace those with things such as pumpkin seeds or sunflower seeds. I'm not the biggest fan of croutons anyways. Don't really like the hard, crunchy bread. And you guys know I'm always putting pumpkin seeds or sunflower seeds on my salad. I just like that better as my crunch. But if you want to eat croutons, it's okay. Just limit your croutons to not eat so many. And your smart points on croutons are actually for a good amount are going to be more than implementing a seed on your salad. And again, the nutritional benefit of having a seed like pumpkin skin or sunflower really outweighs the lack of nutritional benefit of croutons. But again, if you like croutons, there's nothing wrong with putting them on your salad in moderation. And here's the one that I have to disagree on. They are saying to eliminate coconut oil because it's a saturated fat and have all of our avocado oil because it's an unsaturated fat. Okay, so I have to disagree with this. I don't think there's anything wrong with coconut oil. Now, coconut oil has 7 smart points per tablespoon versus 4 points in olive oil or avocado oil. So of course you're going to save some points if you opt for avocado or olive. But I don't think there's anything wrong with coconut oil. Yes, it's a saturated fat. And how you guys can easily know that something is a saturated fat is it is a solid at room temperature. So things like coconut oil, when they're left in your pantry or at room temperature, they solidify. Now, an unsaturated fat like avocado oil or olive oil are going to be liquid at room temperature. So that's a really, really easy way to know if something is unsaturated or saturated. But again, I don't think there's anything wrong with coconut oil. If you want to work it into your points or your calories, it's still a good oil for you. And again, it's saturated, so in moderation. But isn't everything in moderation the way that we should be eating? And lastly is taking a saturated fat like chips and swapping them out for nuts, almonds, pistachios, cashews, walnuts. I like that. I love nuts. I think nuts are great. They're satisfying, they're filling, they're a great source of fat, and they're not too bad in smart points. But I don't think there's anything wrong with having chips every once in a while too. And I'm not saying that WW is saying to completely eliminate saturated fat. They're just giving you some easy swap options. And I think that that's great, especially if you're really concerned about spending your smart points on fats, which a lot of people are. If that wasn't the case, there wouldn't be so many people eating reduced fat, fat-free, low-fat, sugar-free items. They would choose the full fat items in place of those, but they're trying to save their points. So I see where WW is coming from with this topic, because of course unsaturated fat is still going to have points, but it's going to be less compared to saturated fat. The coconut oil is a prime example. 7 points for a tablespoon, or butter, 5 points for a tablespoon versus 4 points for a tablespoon of a healthy oil. So I'm so happy WW addressed fats. Now, I don't entirely agree with their thinking behind the fats. However, I do see where they're coming from, and I just think most importantly, the takeaway is to make sure that you are incorporating some fat into your diet. You should never eliminate a food group. So don't take out fats, just like you wouldn't take out carbohydrates or protein out of your diet. Make sure that you're eating a well-balanced diet, that you are incorporating healthy fats, because it's going to give you satiation from hunger. It's going to give your body what it needs as far as nutrients and vitamins. And it's a great way to feel better. Your skin and your body overall is by incorporating some healthy fat. So you take away from this as you choose. I'm just sharing my opinion and WW's opinion when it comes to healthy fats. So now let's talk a little more about my week. Like I mentioned, I'm so proud of myself. So proud of myself for completing 3 days of Jazzercise. I'm back on the Jazzercise train. And let me just tell you, after doing the first day Saturday, I felt so much better. And I remembered why I love Jazzercise. And I looked forward to my other 2 workouts. So I'm back on track when it comes to getting in my exercise, which is super, super important to me. You guys know that's important for me to feel better. It helps reshape my body, gives me the muscles, which makes me look smaller. So I'm here for it. So I have goals to do Jazzercise 3 days this next week as well. My food went well because I tracked the entire week in both my Lose It app and on WW because I was filming. So it really, really helped me stay on track. That's huge motivation for me. So I did really well with my food. And again, no calorie cycling this last week, but I'm starting today and I'll fill you guys in next Friday on how that went, and we'll see how that affects my weight loss for next Friday. Now, the low of my week happened today. It's here. My favorite time of the month started today. Of course it did. Well, actually last night. I woke up to it this morning. So I was so frustrated because I filmed my video and I really, really wanted to have a good weigh-in after that. But to my surprise, you guys, when I stepped on the scale, I had a great weigh-in despite my time of the month. So I'm telling you, it should have been more had that not started. But when I stepped on the scale, I'm down 1.6. That is fantastic. I am so excited. That means that I have lost every single week in the month of June. I am on track to hit that 4.75 pounds that I need to get one step closer to my 50 pounds lost in 2020. I just put up my updated goals, how I'm doing, video yesterday, Thursday. So check that out if you haven't already seen it. I talk about where I am as far as my weight loss goals, and we kind of recap all my other goals that I had for 2020. So I'm absolutely thrilled with being down 1.6 considering everything. I'm thrilled with 1.6. So that is it for me. That's my week in a nutshell. I'm proud of my exercise. I'm extremely proud of my weight loss, considering my favorite time of the month. But I want to hear from you guys. How was your week? And I definitely want to hear, what are your thoughts on saturated versus unsaturated fats? Are you in my camp where you feel like it's okay to have some saturated fat? Or are you more in the WW camp where you should swap those out for unsaturated fats? I'm just curious what your guys' opinion on this matter are. And just to remind you guys, I'm not a doctor, a dietitian, a nutritionist. This is my personal opinion and my thoughts on this topic. So don't come for me if you disagree. Just simply share what your disagreement is in the comments. I just want to hear what you guys think. I also want to hear how your week went. Did you gain? Did you lose? Was it what you expected? How are you feeling as we venture out of quarantine and back to a normal life? I definitely want to hear from you guys in the comment section. And if you're new, please join my YouTube friends and family. We'd love to have you be part of our community. All you have to do is hit that little subscribe button and the bell next to it so you're notified when new videos are uploaded. Thumbs up this one if you love these weigh-in videos and these little car chats every single Friday. It's honestly one of my favorite videos to do. And I love you guys. I hope you have a fantastic weekend. Stay tuned tomorrow for a grocery haul video, and Sunday is the What I Eat in a Week points versus calories, and it's a long video, so grab a cup of coffee and join me on Sunday's video. Super fun. I'm so happy with how it turned out. Very enlightening. So check that out on Sunday. Happy Friday, friends, and I'll see you all in tomorrow's grocery haul. Bye, guys. My darling, I love you, 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 I love you.